All right, so we are back to the show. Have been trying to find more things on Tumblr. So I stumbled again, and I came up a few more quotes. It says, "You are confined only by the walls you build yourself." I agree. "If you don't know where you're going, any road will get you there." Absolutely. "Take risks. If you win, you will be happy. If you lose, you will be wise." "Learn from yesterday, live for today, hope for tomorrow." And "happiness is when you think what you say and what you do are in harmony." Oh, I like that one. "Happiness is when what you think, what you say, and what you do are in harmony," by Mahatma Gandhi. That's a great little quote, because there's too many people who do not have the three things in concert: thinking, saying, and doing. You know, so many people will do one thing, say another, or think another way. I mean, really, honestly, it's just rampant these days. People are just really fucking two-faced. You can't trust anybody anymore. But anyway, another one says, "Respect yourself enough to walk away from anything that no longer serves you, grows you, or makes you happy. If you aren't being treated with love and respect, check your price tag. Maybe you've marked yourself down. It's you who tells people what your worth is. Get off of the clearance rack and get behind the glass where they keep the valuables." Ooh, I love that. That's from livelifeideal.com. That's really good. I like that a lot. "Respect yourself enough to walk away from anything that no longer serves you, grows you, or makes you happy. If you aren't being treated with love and respect, check your price tag. Maybe you've marked yourself down. It's you who tells people what your worth is. Get off of the clearance rack and get behind the glass where they keep the valuables." That's really great. It reminds me of a quote by Maya Angelou that Oprah says all the time, and I completely agree with. You know, people tell you how to treat them. Excuse me. You tell people how to treat you, rather. And so it's true. I mean, by your actions, by what you put up with, and by what you acknowledge as okay behavior, you're saying that's okay. And sometimes that's marking your own price tag down. And sometimes you're allowing people to say you're not worth it. You're not worthy of love or respect. And I think that's a horrible thing. So then we have Death by Oreo Cupcakes, a recipe. By the way, Oreos are fucking amazing. They're the worst fucking thing in the world you could eat. And I'm trying not to eat bad anymore. The past month or two, I've been eating so not healthy, just because I've been lazy and didn't want to cook or whatever. And and I'd always talk about on my show how you shouldn't eat fast food, blah blah blah, but Michael, it doesn't want to cook on his days, and so I'll cook, and then he didn't want to cook, and so we'll cook you fast food or something, or we'll go sit down at a restaurant sometimes. But anyway, but Oreos are so good. I mean, I haven't had one in a long time, probably a year, maybe two, maybe longer, but they're so fucking amazing. But you can apparently make a Death by Oreo cupcake, and it looks really good. You can go to, where is this? Instructables.com and find the recipe. Looks delicious. All right, next stumble. Oh my God, I didn't know they had these. Oh, wow, this is cool. So remember the game Pac-Man, the game Pac-Man? So apparently there's walkthroughs for Pac-Man. I never even thought about that. What a walkthrough is, if you don't play video games or whatever, a walkthrough is where it tells you exactly what moves to make in order to win the game, right? And so it's got level 1 through 8 listed here. And level 1 says right, up, left, down, right, up, left, right, down, up, up, left, up, right, left. And so it tells you all of the moves to make to win the game the best way with the most points. That's amazing. I'm going to have to save this because I want to try it later. Because I haven't played Pac-Man in a long time, but I have it, I think, on my computer somewhere, or I can download it from the Apple Store or whatever. That's pretty cool. Let me save it. How do I save this? Games. Oh, okay. Well, so on StumbleUpon, you can actually save the things you find, and they can be in your own collection or private, so you can find it again. All right. That's cool. Next stumble. Let's see. No, I got to see that to understand that one. It says 10 easy money earning tips you can use immediately in 2013. Number one, earn free gift cards on swagbucks.com. Swagbucks is an awesome little site I discovered a while back that allows you to earn free gift cards for doing things online. The gift cards are from major retailers like Walmart, Target, and Amazon. I personally like the option to get Amazon gift cards as I make the majority of my online purchases on Amazon. The way it works is Swagbucks rewards you with Swagbucks for doing online tasks such as taking surveys, shopping online, watching videos, playing games, searching the web, etc. The Swagbucks can then be redeemed for gift cards or other rewards. If you're if you're online a lot like myself, then it's pretty easy to start earning rewards. I have a few friends that have paid for their Christmas presents entirely with Swagbucks gift cards. You can check it out over here at swagbucks.com. Awesome. I'm going to try that. That sounds cool. Number two, earn extra cash by taking surveys. If you have extra time and want to make some extra money, there are quite a few online companies that pay you for taking surveys. Now, these surveys will vary in size, topic, and payment, but you can make from $1 to $25 per survey depending upon the length. You can go to mysurvey.com. You can also go to onlycashsurveys, freemoneyblog.net. So that's cool. Number three, shop and earn programs. Swagbucks is one of them. Ebates is another. Ebates, you get to earn rebates from things that you buy online. Number four, sell old electronics on Gazelle. Oh yeah, Gazelle's a cool site. I've actually used them before to sell an old iPhone. Gazelle allows you to turn your old iPhones or iPods, iPads, or other kinds of electronics into cash. So it's pretty easy. You just find the gadget you have on there, you answer a few questions, and you ship it in for free. If it's over a dollar that they're going to pay you, you get paid via check or PayPal. And so you can get my old iPhone I sold for $250 or something like that when I upgraded before to the 5. So yeah, it's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Number five, find a high interest saving account with minimal fees. This is a good one too. Now there used to be a lot more of these because I know I used to have ING Direct, which was Orange, which was you could get 1.2%, 2% interest rate, which is high these days, believe it or not. But they got rid of it. They were bought out by fucking Capital One or some other fucking big bank. I hate Capital One, those banks. I hate big banks. I'm a big hater of banks. I hate banks, period. I think banks are horrible. And someplace you have to actually pay someone to keep your money. I mean, really? Shouldn't they be paying you? Fortunately, I, by the way, have a Schwab account, Charles Schwab. I have it as an investment account. I have my investment accounts there and I have my bank accounts there. And you can deposit your checks online or through your iPhone or electronically like that without having to go to the bank at all. And they also pays interest on your checking account balance. And it's a free account. You don't pay anything for it every month. So it's awesome. So I've been using them for many years. And, I haven't been using Wells Fargo or Bank of America or Chase or any of those in a long time because they're all horrible places. But Charles Schwab has been really good to me, really good customer service, really on the ball, awesome bank. So I would definitely recommend them, by the way. Number six, call to have your current interest rates lowered on your credit cards. Ask and you will be given. Call your current credit card companies and just ask if they can lower the interest rate. They won't always do it, but they will grant your request for lower interest more often than you think. That's good. Number seven, transfer credit card balances to 0% interest rate credit cards. So basically, if you have lots of credit cards, a high credit card balance, or say you have a credit card balance of $10,000 on one card, and you go get a 0% interest rate, then you can on a different card, a new card, you can transfer the balance from the $10,000 card that has maybe a 4% interest rate on it, and you can transfer it to the 0% card and no pay any interest on the money that you were going to be paying 4% on. So that's what they're saying to do. And the last two are number eight, rent out your home on Airbnb when you're out of town. Oh yeah, by the way, Airbnb is a really cool site. I've used it before. Airbnb is really cool because you can go there and you can actually, there's some people who make $50,000 a year renting out their house or whatever. Okay, I'm serious. So you can just, people visit places or whatever. I'm having a hard time talking today, apparently. When you go to visit places like vacations or whatever, instead of staying at a hotel, you can stay at an actual home, like a guest house at somebody's house or like an actual whole house or whatever. And this is what we do because we prefer them over hotels where you get your things stolen sometimes from maids and whatever, which has happened to me. So you can actually go to Airbnb.com and you can actually go search for a place to stay, like in LA, Dallas, New York, San Francisco. Almost every city has, almost all the major cities have places that you can lease. And so you go there, it shows you pictures of it. It shows you the inside of it. Some have video. It shows you the person that's renting it to you. You can rent it for like 1 day, 1 week, 1 month, 1 year. I mean, you can rent it for however long you want for the most part. And depending on how long you rent it, it depends on your rate. And you can rent places for like $50 a night. You can rent places for like $5,000 a night. Places for $50,000 a night. It just depends on how nice of a place you want. You can rent a fucking mansion if you want to. But like going to Los Angeles, for example, if you go there and you want to stay in the Hollywood Hills and you want to stay, or you want to stay in Beverly Hills, you want to stay on Rodeo Drive even, you want to stay in some places that you wouldn't necessarily live in if you live back at home, you can do that. And it's really not as expensive as you would think. And you make a deposit based on the cleaning fee that they charge. They're all different depending on how the size of the house, that kind of thing. And there's no credit check or anything like that if you're worried about that. There's no background checks or anything on you or anything like that. So if you're a criminal, you can still do it, I guess, as well. But it's really cool. So I highly advise going to Airbnb.com and checking it out if you're going to stay anywhere. And also, if you have a place to rent out or something, you can make money doing it. Number nine, use coupons. I have not used a coupon in years. Like mine, when I was a kid, my mom used to use coupons all the time. You know, we go to the grocery store, and it was like a prerequisite to go shopping at the grocery store was to use coupons. And I actually dated a guy when I was 19. We lived together briefly for like 5 months or something like that. It didn't work out, but anyway, and he would take us to go get our groceries, right? We would buy like $200 worth of groceries for $0. He would go on double or triple coupon day. He would have all this. He had literally boxes and boxes full of coupons. I mean, boxes and boxes and boxes, right? And of all these coupons he had, he would take them and he would organize them. I organized them for him because they were really kind of a disarray, but I organized them for him. And anyway, he had them for months and months and months ahead. And he would go buy everything like in bulk or whatever if he could.